In this short tutorial, I'm going to show you click by click how to restore and colorize old photos for free. I'm in Google AI Studio at aistudio.google.com. Clicking on Try Nano Banana, I'm logged in, and I'm going to click this plus sign and upload a file. I'm going to show you two different ways to colorize photos. One's that kind of old-timey tinted way, and the other one is going to be a modern way that looks more like a photograph that was taken today, so you can really see what these young men look like. Wow, I guess they're not even open anymore. This is a picture from 1936, I believe. Before I colorize anything, I like to give it sort of a nice canvas to do that work on. So I want to clean this up. I don't want it to look all yellow. Scraping out the old prompt, pasting in the new prompt, and I'm saying restore this old photo and make it look like a brand new black and white photo. Remove all visible damage and degradation. Sharpen the image to modern high resolution quality. Remove all yellowing. Optimize lighting, contrast, and tonal balance to achieve a pristine, professionally restored result while maintaining original character. Maintain complete fidelity to all human subjects. Preserve original facial features, expressions, body positioning, and clothing without any modifications to the human subjects. So I do this, and you'll see that last line in all of my prompts that I'm using here today. The reason I do that is because as you're working on, I don't know, if you're doing a lot of work in something, maybe you want to change the sky, or you want to add clouds or whatever, and then you look down and somebody's arm got an inch longer. Generally speaking, Google Gemini's modifications that it makes on its own, because sometimes it will just add stuff that makes sense and you're like, I didn't even think of that. That's fantastic. When you're working with preserving historical photos, you just want to see what your great grandpa really looked like on that day. And you really are not looking for Google to be creative with you. You can also be more specific in terms of fine tuning how much latitude Google AI Studio has with the stuff that you see off to the side. But we're just trying to do this fast and easy. So we're just going to run the prompt, and you can copy this prompt so you can use it on your photos as well. Should get a nice clear black and white picture. Yeah, very good. Very good. All right. So now that we have this cleaned up canvas to work with, we're going to do a colorization effect similar to the hand tinting that they used to do on these old photographs. They used to actually paint right on them and paint color on them so they could see themselves in color. And you see those sometimes in antique shops and online. And it's a really cool looking effect. So I've said here, colorize this black and white photo in the classic tinted style. Use gentle pastel washes, hand tinted effect, muted skin tones, and subtle colors for clothing and background. Preserve the vintage texture, film grain, and slight imperfections of the old photograph. The result should look authentically antique and softly colored, like hand-tinted studio portraits from the early 20th century. Maintain complete fidelity to all human subjects. Preserve original facial features, expressions, body positioning, and clothing without any modifications to the human subjects. It's so exciting when you click run, right? Yeah. Oh, that's nice. Just that little bit of color makes them so much more alive. Like, it's so vague and obscure in black and white, especially if it's a real yellowed picture like that. This just really gives you a much better sense of just the energy these young men had. This is beautiful. This is beautiful. I'm very happy with it. All right. The next thing we're going to do is try another style. I'm going to download this just for myself. You can click download. I'm also going to download this nice, what I'm calling our canvas, which is the cleaned up black and white photo, because we're going to use that in a new prompt. I'm not going to continue on here and ask it to colorize it a different way, because there's a chance that it will get confused, and it's much more likely that I'll get a perfect result the first time if I just start from scratch using that black and white photo. So I'm going back to Google AI Studio, Try Nano Banana, plus sign, upload file, and I'm uploading the photo that I just downloaded. And I'm pasting in a prompt here that I have had pretty great success with so far. See if it lets me down this time. I don't think it will. Restore this black and white photo and make it look like a modern, high-resolution digital photograph. Apply realistic, natural skin tones, vivid clothing colors, accurate background hues, and true-to-life lighting. Sharpen image details and textures, and ensure the final result looks as if it was taken today with a professional DSLR camera. The colors and style should be fully modern, with no vintage tinting or artifact left. Maintain complete fidelity to all human subjects. Yada, yada. We had this in the prior prompt as well. Don't mess with my people. All right. So, on the prompt. Yeah. Now, I'm just letting it select the colors when you're working with your own photographs. You're welcome to, especially if you actually know grandma's dress was green, go ahead and put that in there. But I am not unhappy with the choices that are being made just directly from Google Nano Banana. Look at that. I mean, like, it's like a picture you can go outside right now and take. All right. All right. I'm very happy with that result. We're going to try one more. We got time for one more. I'm going to go back to Google AI Studio. Try Nano Banana. Plus sign. Upload file. And now we're going to work on this lovely lady, of this young woman who is standing in front of a tree. Just like we did with the boys, we are going to clean this up, get rid of yellowing, just make it better, and use that as our canvas that we'll use for our colorization. So we'll run that right now. And this is the exact same prompt that I used on the young men as well. All right, excellent. And now we're going to do our first colorization on this lady, and we're going to put in our vintage tinting prompt to make an old-fashioned vintage colorized photo. And I'm going to click run. So exciting. Look at that. Oh, she looks fantastic. Yeah. Man, that's nice. Just gorgeous. All right, we're going to do the same thing with her. Like I did before, I'm going to save down a copy of what I'm calling my canvas here that we're going to use to colorize again. And just like we did before, we're going to open a new chat because we don't want Nano Banana to get confused and have it half colorized and half modern and all that kind of stuff. We just kind of bypass that whole problem by starting a new conversation. So I'm going to click over here, Google AI Studio, Nano Banana, and the plus sign, upload file, upload what I just downloaded, that nice cleaned up black and white photo. And I couldn't stop myself. I added a little bit more to the prompt. And I said, make the greenery look vivid and lush, and make the woman's dress navy blue. All right. Run the prompt. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. That looks fantastic. All right. That's how you colorize photos in just a few clicks and with a few words using AI, using Nano Banana and Google AI Studio. If you found this helpful, please subscribe for more practical AI tutorials.